Welcome to this new how-to. In this how-to, we will discuss how you can configure custom camera views. To do that, we first need to find out which shortcuts we need to use. By default, to create custom camera points, it's the left control key, left alt key, and then the numbers 1 up till 9, or up to 0 actually. To access the custom cameras, you need to hit the left alt key followed by one of the numbers which you assigned to the view. But why do you want to use those custom views? Well, in some cases, right, you can still use the right cursor and then look around if you're lucky and you've got a throttle which has the, for example, the Thrustmaster throttle, right? You can also use it to move around. Or you might have the other joysticks, which have the small joystick on the top, which allows you control the views. But in some cases, it's simply easier to say, okay, hey, if I want to have a look at my throttle, for example, and I want to look like this, then I simply want to press a certain key combination, which will directly show me this view. Well, let's have a look how we can do that. To do that, we need to go to the controls options. And inside the controls options, you will need to go to the keyboard as we're going to assign keyboard shortcuts to it. So you can expand the camera and then expand the cockpit. And here you will see a lot of shortcuts which you can use, including the ones which are already assigned to save the custom camera. As mentioned, you need to use the left control key and left alt key followed by a number, and that will save the camera. So, for example, if I want to save camera 0 to be, looking straight forward, then once I'm happy with the view, I press this key combination and then it's saved. Once you've done that, you, of course, want to load those cameras, and there are multiple options. One of them is to use the left alt key in combination with the key or with the number which you assigned to the camera, right? The other option is to press the letter K from kilo or shift plus the letter K from kilo to move between custom cameras. Sounds nice, right? Well, let's have a look at it. So to reset the view, I'm gonna press Control Space, right? That this simply resets the view to the default view. So let's assume that we want to create a custom view which looks at the throttle. So again, we're gonna zoom in, and once we're happy with this full, we're pressing the left control key, left alt key, followed by a number. In this case, I'm gonna assign number 9 to it. Saved. Then let's have a look what else might be very useful. Well, maybe we want to have one specifically for the autopilot. Well, in that case, Control Alt, and then let's assign it the number 0. Is there something else being useful? Well, maybe you want to look at the top of the aircraft. Again, Control Alt followed by a number, in this case 7. So once everything is done, right, we've assigned the keys. Maybe you want to have some other views, like, for example, this view. Let's assign it the number 2. So let's assume that we want to start the aircraft. Well, let's use the keys, right? Left key plus the number 1 will, in this case, bring us to the default position, which is kind of weird, right? Because we just assigned, a default view to it. So let me press the key combination again. Now it works. This will show us, in this case, actually a handy view of all the things which we need to start the aircraft, right? So once that's done, what do we else want to do? Well, maybe we want to set the autopilot. Or maybe we want to have a look at the top of the aircraft because we need to enable some of the lights, right? The master light, for example, or you want to use this to start the generators. Once that's done, we can continue with the other keys. For example, the number 9, which will show us the throttle. Really easy to use in an aircraft, right? It's far more easier than hovering around with your mouse and looking left and right. Again, it really depends on the controls you're using with Flight Simulator, but I think these custom cameras are really great. Now the downside of those cameras. The downside of the cameras is the following. You need to redo all the custom camera things for every aircraft, which means that if I'm now selecting a different aircraft, these options which we just created will not work. You need to do that manually each time you switch from aircraft, right? So once you've done the aircraft, it will be saved, and then you can simply reuse them. That's because the settings are stored. What are other options? Well, there are not a lot of other options, right? You can define other keys also, because what we just did is use the default keys. Let me show it again, in which were assigned. But if you don't like to press, for example, multiple keys, you can reassign these keys, but you need to be careful about that, because in Flight Simulator, there are a lot of keys which are already assigned. And the good thing is that if you assign a key or a key combination which has already been assigned, Flight Simulator will warn you, and you first need to clear the binding before you're setting up the new binding. Right? So be aware of that. Here ends this how-to. In this how-to, I showed you how you can configure custom cameras. Keep in mind that some of the aircrafts from Flight Simulator already have custom cameras, so try to see if you can reuse them. In some cases, if you don't like them, you can reconfigure them using the same options as I just showed you. I hope you liked this video. If you liked it, then consider to use the like button. If you've got questions or comments, then feel free to post them in the comment box below the video. And if you want to stay up to date about new videos, then consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.